My dear Michael and Teresa, your journey has brought you to this church so that the Lord, who has taken a liking to you, may seal your covenant of love in the presence of me, his minister, and your family and friends. This Lord who loves you, he is pleased with the love that you have for each other. He has consecrated you to himself in baptism, and now he invites you into this special sacrament, so that both of you may love each other and be faithful to each other all the days that you walk on this earth. So in the presence of your God and all here present, I ask you to make your covenant of loving to each other. Michael, have you come here freely and without any question to give yourself to Teresa in this covenant of marriage?
Yes. Okay. I have come here freely and without any question.
Teresa, have you come here freely and without any question to give yourself to Michael in this covenant of marriage?
I will honor Teresa as my wife as long as both of us shall live.
Teresa, will you love and honor Michael as your husband for as long as you both shall live?
I will love and honor Michael as my husband if we both shall live.
Michael, will you accept children as God's gift to you, and will you raise them according to God's way of loving in his church?
I will accept children as God's gift to us, and we will raise them according to God's way of loving his church.
Teresa, will you accept children lovingly from God as his gift to you both, and will you bring them up according to his ways of loving in the church?
I will accept children as God's gift to us, and I will raise them according to God's way of loving in his church.
Now, we would ask you to, since you are now ready to enter into this covenant of love, join your hands together and make the promises of this covenant.
In this commitment of marriage to you. I promise to communicate to you in a respectful and loving manner. I promise to provide support to you in the achievement of your goals and ours. I promise to walk with you hand in hand and be your life partner. And I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad times, in sickness and in health, and I will honor you for the rest of our life's journey.
Mike, I'm in love with you. You are so amazing to me, and I love being around you. And when I'm not with you, I feel like I'm just waiting to be with you. And really, no words could express how strong my feelings are for you. And I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad times. And in sickness and in health, I will love you. And I will honor you for the rest of our life.
Michael and Teresa, you have entered a covenant with your God in the presence of family and friends. May this God who loves you and watch over you and fill your lives with blessings, the people who God has called together must now walk in his sight and be pleasing to him.
Now we come to bless the rings. And as Dave comes to bless your rings, we would remind you that rings are only rings are only rings. And when you put them on, they take on a whole new life. With this blessing, special blessing that Dave puts on these rings, your rings become extremely special. Because anywhere you are, when you're away from each other, all you do is close your eyes and rub the ring with your thumb, and you'll know exactly where your loved one is. In fact, if you rub it hard enough, you'll be able to see where they are. That's the gift. Because like you said, when you are apart, there's part of you that is missing. So in the blessing of sharing of these rings that are blessed now for you, God looks upon you again and gives you another symbolism of how you dedicate and consecrate yourself to each other.
Lord, bless these rings which we bless in your name. Grant that those who wear them may always have a deep faith and love in each other. Bless and consecrate Michael and Teresa in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of their true faith in each other and always remind them of their love.
You give each other these coins. They have been blessed. These are a symbolism of worldly goods that you share with each other. Not alone, it's impossible to share your life and your souls with each other unless you share your worldly goods with each other. As you give these and place them in Teresa's hands, Michael, you will say, Teresa, take these coins as token of all my worldly goods.
All right. Teresa? Take these coins as a token of all my worldly goods.
Teresa, give them back. Michael, take these coins.